What is going on YouTube? It's Cody here from Big Time Battery and Electronics, bringing you guys some more of that big time information. Today, we're going to be setting our focus on the difference between UHF, or ultra high frequencies, and VHF, or very high frequencies. These terms may be more relevant and common to those currently using two-way radios, but to begin, the main difference resides in the range of the frequency spectrum, which will be displayed on the screen now. First, we see VLF, indicating very low frequency. Next to it, we'll see LF, or low frequency. Next, MF, or medium frequency. Then, HF, for high frequency. Finally, next we have VHF, or very high frequency. So in result, the bare minimum electromagnetic wave frequency that could be classified as a VHF, or very high frequency wave, would have to be at least 30 MHz or 30 Hz. And the absolute highest frequency could be no higher than 300 MHz, or again, 300 Hz. To conclude, a VHF frequency must fall between 30 Hz and 300 Hz for it to be a true VHF wave. Next on our chart here, to the right of VHF, we will see UHF, or ultra high frequency, with the range starting at 300 MHz, or Hertz, and all the way up to 3 GHz, or 3 GHz. Radio waves in the UHF band travel almost entirely by line of sight propagation and ground reflection. Line of sight propagation is a characteristic of electromagnetic radiation, which means waves travel in a direct path from the source to the receiver, as shown by the picture displayed. Ground reflection is a radio propagation model that predicts path loss when the signal received consists of the line of sight component and multiple path components formed by predominantly a single ground reflected wave. In layman's terms, look at the picture displayed as a signal lost through the original output through a line of sight is dispersed toward the ground reflection, where it is ultimately sent back to the desired destination. Hopefully. To conclude, radio waves in a UHF band travel almost entirely by line of sight propagation, or LOS, and ground reflection. There is very, very little reflection from the ionosphere, or Earth's atmosphere, and very little reflection from the ground wave. All in all, think of UHF waves as shorter length waves, but at a higher frequency range, which is why they penetrate walls and objects more effectively than their VHF counterparts. Almost 99.9% of two-way radio users will want to go with a UHF radio, considering their usage is more reliable in cities, buildings, and urban environments. VHF, which is more towards places like farms, ranches, and those more rural areas with a vast amount of space and low amounts of physical obstructions. I leave you with this last bit of information. Think of a VHF wavelength as a 7-foot pole. Moving in a vicinity such as a warehouse, even a small room, it is very hard to do without anything diminishing the signal or hitting it, obstructing it. This wavelength indicates how hard it is for a VHF wave to be transmitted in these types of environments. As you turn with the 7-foot pole, it can't help but hit or hit something that is going to diminish the wave. But if it was in a field or in an open area or a land that had nothing surrounding it, it could travel or move with ease. Now think of a UHF wave, which will be indicated by a 3-foot pole. It moves easily and effectively, indicating how much easier it is for this signal to be transmitted in close quarter environments. I hope this helped you guys learn more about VHF and UHF frequencies and two-way radios as a whole. Questions, comments, concerns, leave them below and we'll be sure to get back to you. Don't forget to help us out by smashing that subscribe button. It's been Cody over here from Big Time Battery and Electronics. Thanks for watching.